All right, my friends, let's try out a solution. Well, as usual, I'm going to first put in my select keyword, but I'm not going to select any columns just yet until I have a really good idea of the structure of data that I'm going to end up with. Next, I'm going to specify the source of all the different rows I want to work with. That's definitely going to be all the rows of the phones table. So I'll do a from phones. I'm then going to immediately apply a group by step. So I'm going to group all these rows together based upon their manufacturer. I'll then have those different groups of Apple, Nokia, Samsung, and so on. So I'll do a group by manufacturer, and again, double check your spelling on manufacturer right there. We'll then start to filter down these different groups. So anytime that we're doing a filter on a group, we're going to use that having keyword. And then inside this having statement, we want to do some filtering using a aggregate function, because we want to sum up the revenue of every phone inside of each group. So I'm going to do a sum of price times units sold. So remember, price times units sold right here, that's going to be executed for every single row. And then the result of that multiplication will all be added together using sum. Okay, so that should be it for filtering out, or getting that initial sum right there. So then to do the actual filter, we only want to take a look at manufacturers where that sum or that total revenue is greater than 2 million. So I'll put in a greater than and then 2 million. I'm only putting in commas just so it's very clear that I'm putting in 2 million here. We can't add in commas in SQL and a number, so I am going to delete those. Okay, so now that we've got that filtering complete, we can now select some actual columns. So I want to see the manufacturer, and then I want to print out that manufacturer's total revenue. So to print out that total revenue, we can do that same calculation once again. So I'll do a sum of price times units sold. And that should be it. All right, so let's check our solution and see how we're doing. All right, looks good. So I've got Apple and Samsung. Looks like they both have revenue greater than 2 million. Well, hopefully you came up with the solution as well. If you didn't, don't sweat it. As usual, you're going to have a lot of opportunities for practice throughout the rest of the course.